गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ माई लेक्चर नंबर 2 फॉर पोयम नंबर 6 आंट जेनिफर्स टाइगर्स, रिटन बाय एड्रिन रिच, फॉर क्लास 12th, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश, बुक फ्लेमिंगो। चिल्ड्रन, इन लेक्चर नंबर 1 ऑफ दिस पोयम आई टॉट यू द कंप्लीट पोयम। आई टॉट यू द लिटरेरी डिवाइसेस यूज्ड बाय एड्रिन रिच इन दिस पोयम, एंड इन दिस लेक्चर I will recapitulate what was taught in lecture number 1, that means complete explanation of the poem, and then I'll discuss the textual exercise that has been given at the back of this poem in your book Flamingo. So let's start the poem with its recapitulation. Now I am going to recapitulate the complete poem with its explanation for your better understanding.
Aunt Jennifer's tigers means the tigers that she is embroidering onto a panel, onto a screen. They are moving with high steps and it appears as if they are moving with high steps that they are going across a screen. And those tigers which she is embroidering are bright topaz denizens of a world of green. World of green means forest. Denizens means inhabitants. And then Edrin Rich tells that they are bright like topaz. Topaz is a precious gem that is yellow in color. So to describe the bright color of the tigers, this word topaz is written by the poet. She says that Aunt Jennifer is creating the tigers onto a screen, onto a piece of cloth, and it appears that those tigers are very bright yellow in color and they are the inhabitants of jungle. And she says they means the tigers, do not fear the men beneath the tree. Here it is given beneath the tree, that symbolizes the ordinary people. The poet says the tigers which he is creating to represent the fear among the humans, she says that these tigers have no fear of ordinary people. They pace means move in sleek means delicate, chivalric certainty. Chivalric means polite, certainty means helpfulness. So the poet Edrin Rich says that the tigers created by Aunt Jennifer are so real in their look as it appears that they are moving across the screen where they are embroidered, and they are bright in color, that is their yellow color, and they appear as if they are the real inhabitants of the world of green, that is jungle. And they are bold enough, they do not have any fear of the men beneath the tree, means they do not have any fear of ordinary people, and they are moving with delicate, polite and helpful steps into the jungle, right? So this is the complete explanation of first 4 lines of the poem, in which the poet has added the words like denizens and chivalric to understand the tiger's attitude. They live far away from human settlements. They are called chivalric. This indicates the majestic and honorable position that they occupy in the world of animals. So, the use of the words denizens and chivalric add to the understanding of the tiger's attitude, that they are in full attitude because they are considered the king of the jungle. Aunt Jennifer's fingers fluttering through her wool find even the ivory needle hard to pull. The massive weight of uncle's wedding band sits heavily upon Aunt Jennifer's hand. So you would have noticed द राइमिंग स्कीम दैट आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू ए बी बी सो इट इज वूल पूल बैंड हैंड इन दिस सेकेंड स्टेंजा द रियालिटी ऑफ आंट जेनिफर इज रिवील्ड एज शी इज फीबल वीक एंड एनस्लेव्ड एंड दैट इज वेरी मच द ऑपोजिट ऑफ द टाइगर्स दैट शी वॉज निटिंग दैट शी वॉज एम्ब्रॉयडरिंग सो हर फिजिकल एंड मेंटल ट्रॉमा इज डिपिक्टेड इन द लाइन दैट शी फाइंड्स इवन द आइवरी नीडल हार्ड टू पुल इवन दो शी फाइंड्स दैट द आइवरी नीडल इज वेरी हार्ड फॉर हर टू पुल बिकॉज शी इज एम्ब्रॉयडरिंग द टाइगर्स ऑन टू ए पैनल एंड शी इज दैट मच टेरिफाइड ड्यू टू द ऑपरेशन ऑफ हर हजबेंड दैट हर फिंगर्स आर फ्लटरिंग थ्रू हर ऊल बिकॉज फॉर एम्ब्रॉयडरिंग द टाइगर्स शी हैज वन पैनल इन हर हैंड एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ ऊल एंड आइवरी नीडल शी इज एम्ब्रॉयडरिंग दोज टाइगर्स ऑन टू दैट पैनल सो द पॉइट इन ऑर्डर टू प्रेजेंट द वीकनेस एंड द फीबलनेस ऑफ आंट जेनिफर राइट्स दैट शी इज दैट मच टेरिफाइड शी फाइंड्स इवन द आइवरी नीडल दैट शी इज यूजिंग टू एम्ब्रॉयडर द टाइगर्स वेरी हार्ड टू पुल बिकॉज हर फिंगर्स आर फ्लटरिंग बैडली फ्लटरिंग मीन्स दे आर ट्रेम्बलिंग सो एंड शी राइट्स द मैसिव वेट ऑफ अंकल्स वेडिंग बैंड सिट्स हेविली अपॉन हर हैंड इवन दो अ वेडिंग रिंग डज नॉट वे मच यू नो दिस वेरी वेल सो द मैसिव वेट ऑफ अंकल्स वेडिंग बैंड शी फाइंड्स इट सिटिंग वेरी हेविली अपॉन हर हैंड That signifies the amount of dominance her husband has exercised over her. This also means that her inner free spirit has been jailed by the patriarchal husband. So, here it is. The poet writes that she is that much terrified that her fingers are fluttering And she finds even the needle very hard to pull from the wool. And then she finds that the massive weight of uncle's wedding band, the bonding of the uncle's relation with her was very heavy to bear anymore. And she finds as if this relationship is sitting like a heavy burden onto her hand And she finds herself unable to carry this relationship very difficult to proceed further with the relation of the uncle. So, what does it mean when she writes the massive weight of uncle's wedding band? Children, this expression is symbolic of male authority and power. Matrimony seems to bind the woman physically as well as mentally. The wedding band was a burden for her as she was not getting enough freedom to express herself because of the domestic responsibilities and restrictions put on her as a woman by her husband. When aunt is dead, her terrified hands will lie still ringed with the ordeals she was mastered by. The tigers in the panel that she made will go on prancing, proud and unafraid. In these four lines, the poet Adrian Rich talks about the Aunt Jennifer's death. She finds that this stanza, she starts on a creepy note about her death. Even her death would not free her from the ordeals she was through, which she can be seen in When aunt is dead, her terrified hands will lie still ringed with ordeals she was mastered by. But her artwork which she was, her escape route or in the way, her inner sense of freedom will stay forever proud and unafraid. So what does she tell us in the lines? That even after death, aunt created her fear of her domineering husband, as she would yet bear the burden of the wedding band on her finger. The ordeals faced by her in an oppressive marriage would continue to terrify even after her death. Children, we must know what is the meaning of ordeals here. Aunt Jennifer has been living her life in accordance with the rules laid down by her husband. Her life lacks expression and is overburdened by the demands and duties of her married life. Although old and weak, she still has to face her husband's oppression. These are the ordeals that the poet is talking about in the poem. And then the poet uses the word ringed also. So the use of this word ringed in the poem is significant and appropriate because it correctly represents the vicious cycle created by the norms of society from which Aunt Jennifer is unable to free herself. The word ringed not only indicates that she is wearing her wedding ring, but also that she is bound with the responsibilities, fear, and oppression of her marriage for entire life and probably after it too. So this ringed word is used to express that even after her death, she would not be able to free herself from the fear of her husband. And in the last two lines, the poet writes, "The tigers in the panel that she made." As in the beginning I told you that she is embroidering, she is knitting the tigers onto a panel. So the poet writes, "The tiger in the panel that she made will go on prancing, proud and unafraid." Here the poet tells us that the tigers which she has created into the panel will never be affected. They will go on prancing, they will go on feeling proud, and they will remain always unafraid. Why do you think that she created the tigers which are quite different from her own character? Children, the timid and fearful Aunt Jennifer created an alternative world of free and fearless tigers to express that she also had a desire for freedom, a medium of escape from her grim marriage. So she created the tigers which are unafraid, proud, and will go on prancing in order to express her inner feelings that being a human, she also wanted to live a free life that she had never enjoyed throughout her married life. Therefore, the poet has written in the last two lines that the tigers in the panel that she made will go on prancing, proud and unafraid.
So children, this was the complete recapitulation of the poem, Aunt Jennifer's Tigers. Now we are proceeding towards the exercise given in your main course book, Flamingo. That begins with the head, think it out. And you see there are total 8 questions in number that we have to discuss, which you are supposed to write in your Fair English notebook as well. So let's begin with question number 1, that is, how do denizens and chivalric add to our understanding of the tiger's attitude? Children, like all beasts of prey, the tigers are the denizens of forest. They live far away from human settlements. They are called chivalric. This indicates the majestic and honorable position that they occupy in the world of animals. So the use of the words denizens and chivalric add to our understanding of the tiger's attitudes. Children, denizens, I told you while I was explaining the poem, that is inhabitants. And the poet has written in the poem that they are the inhabitants of the world of green, means they live in jungle. So these words the poet has written to our understanding to teach us the tiger's attitude, because both these words indicate the majestic and honorable position that the tigers are occupying in the world of animals. Now let's discuss question number 2, that is, Why do you think Aunt Jennifer's hens are fluttering through her wool in the second stanza? And why is she finding the needle so hard to pull? Though this question has already been explained in the explanation of the poem, but still I tell you, Aunt Jennifer's hands are fluttering. Fluttering means shivering. Through her wool, as it was taught in the poem that she is embroidering tigers onto a panel. So she has wool, she has used wool and the needle in order to embroider those tigers. And while she is busy in doing that job, she finds her fingers are fluttering through her wool because she is an old lady on whom age has taken its toll. And the fluttering of Aunt Jennifer's fingers also signify her oppressed mental condition, which makes it difficult for her even to pull an ivory needle while embroidering. Now I'll discuss question number 3 with you. What is suggested by the image massive weight of uncle's wedding band? Children, the wedding band that the poet talks about is not the wedding ring that she is wearing in her hand or fingers, but it is the bond of the relationship when she got married with her husband, right? So most of the time people take it in the wrong manner. They think that massive weight of uncle's wedding band. Band refers to the ring that somebody wears in order to symbolize that she is married. But that is wrong. So here wedding band the poet is talking about is not any sort of wedding ring or something that will symbolize that she is married. The image massive weight of her wedding band suggests that she was overburdened with duties and responsibilities post her marriage. Right? That after she got married with uncle, she was overburdened with duties and responsibilities. That is the weight she finds very heavily sitting on her hand. Therefore, she says, massive weight of uncle's wedding band sits heavily upon my hand. So here she tells us that the weight is of the wedding band that has put burden on her head with duties and responsibilities, and she is badly oppressed by her husband. Therefore, she finds it is difficult for her to tolerate this relationship anymore. Now we are proceeding towards question number 4. Of what or of whom is Aunt Jennifer terrified within the third stanza? Children, if you have understood the poem completely, then you would have noticed from beginning till end, she is terrified from her husband only, right? So there is nothing new if the writer mentions in the third stanza or somewhere. But in third stanza, he has laid stress on even after her death, she would be, not be freed. She would not be able to make herself free from the wedding band or the tortures she had to bear throughout her life. So here, even after death, aunt carried her fear of her domineering husband as she would yet bear the burden of the wedding band on her fingers. The ordeals faced by her in an oppressive marriage would continue to terrify her. So of what or of whom is she terrified? She is terrified of her husband only. Now I am discussing question number 5 with you. What are the ordeals Aunt Jennifer is surrounded by? Why is it significant that the poet uses the word ringed? What are the meanings of the word ringed in the poem? Children, what are the ordeals that she is surrounded by? The ordeals are obeying her husband's orders, fear of men. Okay, Aunt Jennifer has been living her life in accordance with the rules laid down by her husband. Her life lacks expression and is overburdened by the demands and duties of her married life. Although old and weak, she still has to face her husband's oppression. These are the old deals that the poet talks about in the poem. And now the second part of the question is, why is it significant that the poet uses the word ringed? Ringed indicates poet has used this word ringed in the poem. That is the significant and appropriate because it's correctly representing the vicious cycle created by the norms of society from which Aunt Jennifer is unable to free herself. She is trapped where her body and soul both are trapped, struggling for freedom and fearlessness throughout her life. And she finds the poet has used this word ringed because there is no exit possible for her now. And what are the meanings of the word ringed in the poem? The word ringed not only indicates that she is wearing any sort of wedding, band, but also that is bound by the responsibilities, fear and oppression of her marriage for entire life and probably after it too. Therefore, the poet has used the word ringed in order to make us understand that she has no possible exit in order to make herself free from this bonding of marriage. That is not a relationship, but a burdensome relation that she is bearing for years and years. Now, I am discussing question number 6 with you. Why do you think Aunt Jennifer created animals that are so different from her own character? You know, she has created the animals that are fearless, proud, prancing, unafraid. And she herself has fear of her husband. She is afraid of her husband. She finds that marriage relationship is the relationship that has curtailed her liberty. So why do you think that she has created the animals that are so different from her own character? And what might the poet be suggesting through this difference? So the answer you can write for this question is, the timid and fearful Aunt Jennifer creates an alternative world of free and fearless tigers to express her longing for freedom. Longing means desire. Right? She created so different tigers from her character in order to express her longing for freedom, a medium of escape from her grim marriage. The ironical contrast underscores a warning by the poet against acceptance of subjugation by women as it crushes their dreams, individuality and full life. So, she created the tigers far different from her own character. Question number 7. Interpret the symbols found in this poem. What are the symbols you have noticed in the poem? You see, in the beginning, the second line, the poet writes, denizens of a world of green, means inhabitants of the forest. Right? So, this is a symbol used here. Massive weight of uncle's wedding band, means the burden of marital obligations. So this is also a symbolic meaning. Sits heavily upon aunt's hand, means has laid a lot of stress on her. So here also it is symbol used. Ringed with ordeals, means to get entrapped in hardships and sufferings. So these are the symbols that the poet has used in the poem, which we can interpret. You see, you notice these symbols and underline them in your book only. Let's proceed towards the last question, that is question number 8 in your exercise, which is, do you sympathize with Aunt Jennifer? What is the attitude of the speaker towards Aunt Jennifer? After reading the complete poem, being humans, yes, the character of Aunt Jennifer wins our sympathy as readers, isn't it? So I repeat, yes, the character of Aunt Jennifer wins our sympathy as readers. Her ordeals and sufferings move to readers. Even the speaker in the poem shows sympathy and pity towards her. The speaker says that even after Aunt Jennifer's death, she will be terrified of her husband and the ordeals of her marriage. So this is the attitude of the speaker towards Aunt Jennifer. These words express that the speaker is also sympathizing with that poor lady who has been tortured by her husband for years and years. Therefore, she finds this marriage relationship is a burdensome that she is unable to carry or hold anymore. So children, this was the complete explanation of the exercise that I have discussed with you. And after attending this lecture, you are supposed to learn and write all these discussed question answers, which are 8 in number, in your Fair English notebook. And children, do not delay. Send me homework regularly and attend your lectures regularly. Thank you. Stay at home, stay happy and healthy. Have a nice day.